All right, well, are y'all ready? Is this what you've been waiting for?
Yeah!
All the way out to California 4 years ago to see him. This guy has an unbelievable business. Last month, he's married, he has a beautiful daughter. Last month, he did $250,000 through First Generation Premium, his base shop, 100 by 100. But, like, you know, he does that every month. Wow, right? Man, we took him to get something to eat, lunch.
Oh, pretty nice.
Went and got in his hotel room, right. Got out fresh enough, he got on his $1,000 Louis Vuitton. No, his Versace shoes. His $1,000 Versace shoes. Versace, come on. How many times have you been MVP, Art?
Four-time
MVP in a row with the company. Four times in a row. He's the leader of the chosen ones. $500,000 earner, near-term NSD. Give it up for the unbelievable Arthur Marzia!
Or they're about to go full-time, you know, and sold out. But I just want to give a quick shout-out to Charles Whitener for having me, and TK for, man, just this guy is unbelievable, man. Just the hospitality that he's shown here so far, I really appreciate it, brother. Thank you, man, okay, for taking care of me. Those ribs. Y'all ready for an explosive weekend, a life-changing weekend?
Yes!
I'm excited to be here, like I said. I want to just kind of go back a few years, you know, as I walked up here with my $1,000 Versace shoes on. It wasn't always like that, okay? I want to take you back February 2010, and you know, the numbers that we did that month, we did 6,000 production, six recruits in the base shop, and made absolutely no money that month.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't want you to feel sorry for me because, you know, it's business, and I can talk straight to you guys, right?
Yes.
I might drop a couple F-bombs and stuff, but you know my heart's in the right place.
Right.
So I'll apologize in advance. But I'm a whole man, I'm going to try not to, but sometimes it does slip up. Business, you know, I will say this. There's risk in business, yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. And there's reward in business, yes or no?
Yes.
And you got to look at the risk. Because everybody wants the reward.
Yes, absolutely.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Everybody wants the reward. You know, if we spend some time today and talk about what's the reward that business offers, you know, we could spend all day talking about that, yes or no?
Yes.
You know, the unlimited income potential, unlimited lifestyle potential, you know, you changing your family's financial tree forever, you know, there's a whole bunch of reward. Well, let's talk about the risk for a second, okay? And what's the risk? I'm not even talking about Primerica. I'm just talking about business in general. What's the risk in business? You guys are smart. What's the risk in business? You invest your money, you not get it back. Now think of our investment, 124, and you get that back. But a real business, right? You're dropping 10, 20. $100,000, $500,000 in a real business, right? You might not get that back, but you got to the point. What else can happen in business? Huh?
It could fold.
No sales, no customers. What else? You get sued, yes or no? You go bankrupt, yes or no?
Yes.
You can lose your car, yes or no?
Yes.
I never lost a car. I had a car taken from me, but I never lost one. I never woke up one day and go, dude, where's my car? I left it here. Oh, they took it. Okay. And by the way, if it was your car, they wouldn't have taken it. It wasn't your car, it's the bank's car. You know what I'm talking about?
Right.
That's a different meeting. So what else? I mean, you lose back credit, yes or no? So all that's a risk. And you look at an NFL player, you look at an NBA player, do they have risk?
Yes.
They go the whole year, they're going the whole pretty much lifetime, from maybe 4 years old to 19 years old, and they don't get paid a what? They don't get paid a dime. And they eat right and they work out, yes or no? Right. And they follow a regimen, and some of you were athletes, you know what I'm talking about? Right, you can't go out all the time, there's what, there's risk there. You could get hurt in the field, yes or no?
Yeah.
And they play that game for years, and they don't make any money. Years they eat right, and they don't make any money. And what are the chances of them going pro? It's slim to none, yes or no?
Yes.
And people sign up for that all day, every day. Soccer, basketball, an actor, an actress, yes or no? There's risk, is my point. But on the other side, so why do they eat well? Why do they show up to practice? Why do they live? Why do they do right? Because they want the what? They want the reward. And we all know that NFL stands for not for long. Because you could get drafted, and the day you get drafted, you could be an instant millionaire, yes or no?
Right.
If you ever watched the NFL draft, you ever watched those people, you ever watched that, and they call their names of the person that got drafted, they start crying. Yes or no?
Yes.
And their mama start crying, yes or no? Because mama knows, I just got me a house. I just got me a house right now.
For real.
I took care of it, he owed me, yes or no? Right, so everyone's life is about to change. Yes or no?
Yes.
But even then, when you sign that contract, guess what? It's not a guaranteed contract. There's another year coming around with better players, yes or no?
Yes.
That wants that same spot. You might get hurt in the field, yes or no?
Yes.
You might die in the field, but people play. So in business, guess what? There's risk, and there's what? There's rewards. Now, I'm just going to be straight with you. If you're not willing to go to the risk, then you don't deserve the reward. If you're not willing to go, not that you have to go to the risk, not that you have to go through that stuff, but if you're not willing to go through it, then you definitely don't deserve the reward.
Right.
That's like a verse to say, man, you know, we're going to have a lotto draft pick for the top 5 NFL players, but you never played the football game. And we're going to draft, that never happened. Yes or no?
Right.
So all those people that played the game, all those people that work out, they know what? They have to go through it. So in 2010, do you think I was living the dream at 6,000 production, 0 recruits and 0 pay? I think I owed the company money. I wasn't living the dream. I was sound a dream and living the nightmare. I'm just being real. We're talking full-timers.
Yeah.
Yes or no?
Yeah.
So you understand the risk. Life wasn't good. But a couple points I want to give to you that really changed our business in the next couple of months, the next couple of years, that I know that if you implement, it'll change your business too. And the first thing you have to do is you have to hold yourself accountable to somebody. I've never seen a person make it by themselves. I've never seen an athlete, a gold medalist, make it by themselves. I've never seen a person that won the Oscar award get up and say, I want to thank me by myself. I've never seen that. Does that make sense? I've never seen a person win a Grammy and get up on stage and go, you know, if it wasn't for me.
That's right.
Does that make sense? When you watch an NFL player or NBA player win a championship, they thank their coach first. Yes or no?
Yes.
And then they thank their mama. They thank their coach, because now without the coach being in my life, without a coach being in my ear, guess what? They would have never brought out the greatness in me. And we all have greatness in us, yes or no?
Yes.
But you are not being great if you're not accountable to somebody. You should write this down. Remember, accountability has accounts in it.
Hmm.
Accountability has a countenance. And if you ain't have no accountability in your life, then guess what? You probably ain't got no money in your account. At 6,000 production, 6 recruits, 0 pay, do you think I was highly accountable to somebody at that time?
No.
And I could have easily said what? I'm just going to keep going and keep going and keep going and keep going and keep going until I figure this out myself. But folks, have you ever been on a road trip before?
Yes.
The road trip starts off fun, yes or no?
Yeah.
You start out with some music, and then you're going, and you go, dude, this don't look, I don't recognize it. And then you turn the music down for some reason. And you tell everyone to be quiet, like, hey, be quiet. Yes or no, I can go out there, be quiet. And all you have to do is what? Pull over.
Mm-hmm.
And ask for directions.
Right.
All you got to do is pull over and ask for directions. Ask Charles Widener for directions. Ask Issa Powell for directions. Ask TK for directions. Because obviously they've been to where you want to go.
Absolutely.
So why would you try to figure this out by yourself? You ain't that damn good. I'm sorry. And I wasted time trying to figure it out by myself and not being accountable to somebody. And folks, to go to 6,000, 6 recruits and no money, that didn't happen in 1 month. That's months after months after months of not being accountable to somebody.
You're good.
So I got tired of it. I got tired of saying, you know what, man, I'm not winning like I used to. I'm supposed to be somebody. I told too many people already that, man, I'm going to be a millionaire. I can't go back to a job. I'm not quitting. I'm going to make this work. Because I know Primerica works, yes or no?
Yes.
If Primerica works, you got to make it work.
Yes.
So I called my coach. Some of you know him, Gary Cornegay. I called Black Mex. He's black, I'm messing. You mix him, you know what I'm talking about. And I called him up and I said, bro, we got to get together. We gotta get together. We gotta get together. We got together, and I'll never forget this conversation. And all he told me was this, and he fixed me like this. He fixed me like that. I went home, I walked back to my car, and I was fixed. Accountability was the first thing. Your attitude is the second thing. Your attitude is the second thing. Mm-hmm. What you tell yourself the first 5 minutes of the day determines your day. Exactly. If you tell yourself, oh man, my day sucks, guess what? You're gonna have a sucky ass day. But if you tell yourself, man, great things always happen to me, great things always happen to me, guess what? Great things will eventually happen to you. You might not believe that. Me and TK were having lunch and we're big on that stuff. Back in the day, I'm sure, because you know, I grew up in the hood, we used to think that stuff was stupid. Like, how's it thinking? That's so dumb. Like, who does that? Only rich people? Ghetto people don't do that. Rich people do that. Positive thinking. And here's what he told me. He said, Art, he said, are you going to be a millionaire one day? And I said, yeah. He said, how would your attitude be if you're a millionaire? And I said, excited. He said, then be excited now while you're broke. Yeah. Be excited right now while you're broke. Because if you're excited right now while you're broke, guess what? When you become a millionaire, you're going to be the same person, and money don't change you.
Right.
Be okay right now while you're broke. Don't let money, don't let premium, don't let recruiting, don't let recognition, don't let nothing control your happiness. You control your happiness.
Exactly.
Don't even let your spouse control your happiness. Hello. I'm adding my stuff on there now. Remember, you're either the thermostat in someone's life or you're the thermometer.
Yeah.
And the thermostat, guess what, sets the temperature.
Right.
The thermometer reads the temperature. The thermometer, it has zero ability to do nothing, but the thermostat does. The thermostat can turn it up or turn it down. The thermostat will change everyone's environment. So when people come to your life, are you the thermostat? Because you need to be a thermostat. When they leave you, they need to be what? Fired up, excited about what's going on in their life. Or you're the thermometer, you're the dump truck. Everyone coming in with their problems.
Right.
Beep, beep, what's going on? I'm just going to dump on you. Or you pitch your positive battery and negative battery. You might be positive that day and someone might be like, thermostat thermometer. Don't let anyone control your happiness. Nobody. My kids don't control my happiness. I wake up and guess what? I'm fired up. My wife goes, are you on drugs? No, I'm just high for life. I'm serious. I get them to be happy when they wake up. How about that one? Does that make sense? I don't let bills, I don't let nothing control my happiness. I'm happy the freaking second I wake up. And if you're good, you might get 5 minutes of pissing me off. If you're good, I give you 5 minutes. After that, what do they say? If negative is in your mind, you need to raise the rent and kick them out.
Mm-hmm.
Raise the rent and kick them out. You don't get that. You don't get to control my day. When a person says, oh, I'm having a bad day, dude, the day just starts. It's 11 o'clock. Day just started. Attitude is everything. Attitude is everything. So when he told me that, I went to my car, and guess what? I was happy in my purple Ford Ranger. Because it wasn't a purple Ford Ranger no more. It was a purple Ford Ranger, but it wasn't no more. I was driving my dream car, which is a Ferrari. Just gave me a lot of problems. So when you have accountability and your attitude is right, and you wake up every day and you go, you know what? I'm in the greatest business opportunity in the world. Now you kind of have to go about the fundamentals. And the first fundamental, you gotta go, and this is the beauty of Primerica, but this is what people knock about Primerica, is recruiting. It's recruiting. Ugh, recruiting? How'd you get your job? You got recruited, yes or no?
Yes.
Thank God for recruiting. Thank God for the C word called commission. Oh my God. Commission? Oh, commission's bad for a lazy person. And by the way, you love commission. No, I don't. I would never be on commission. No, you love commission. No, I don't. Yes, you do. Because your boss is commission. So you better love commission. You better kiss your boss. Never mind. Anyway. Listen. Sprint wide. People gotta see each other's faces. A lot of the people I talk to in Primerica, they hire one direct, and they slow dance to them. You know it's up. They slow dance with them, and I'll pick you up, and I'll buy you dinner after op night, and you just please stay. And he is doing all that stuff, and guess what happens a couple months after that? They leave. And you take it personal, like he's that damn good or something. Who are you where people can't quit? Hey, how about Jesus? How many directs did he hire? 12, and one quit. And you didn't walk on no water? Yes or no? You ain't taking no 2 loaves of bread? You ain't done none of that. Who are you where people can't quit? You need to have an owner mentality.
Mm-hmm.
When a person opens a Subway, what do they have to do? They got to hire and recruit people, yes or no?
Yes.
Now, do all of them stick at Subway?
No.
What happens? They eventually what? Quit. Now, does the owner, you ever see the owner crying in the parking lot? Talking about my sandwich technician, dude. I ain't going to do it. Man, this guy was the best freaking lettuce cutter in the world. You know what I think? I'm going to shut down my store. That's never happened. What do they do?
I knew it. That's right.
Yeah. They keep hiring, yes or no? Yeah. Part of the business is what? It's risk. They're going to hire people, they're going to quit. Stop feeling sorry for yourself. I probably hired more people. I had probably more people quit than you'll ever hire. You want to be a sharpshooter. When they go, when Keith asks you, what's your goal for this month? You go, Keith, I'm going to hire one person. And he asks you for next month, did you hire one person? No, Keith, I'm still on them. Trust me, though, eventually I'm going to get there. But what about the 30 million people? The past five, this last month, what about those? No, once I get this one, once I get this one, and you up in the tree for the whole year. Talking about I'm a zero zero, but yeah, I'm telling you. And then he signed up under another office. You devastated. Well, you gotta be like in the hood of this type of business, or you gotta have a machine gun mentality. You just friggin'. Because even the ricochet gonna hit somebody. Yes,
right.
Damn, I got one, dude. That's the mentality, the freaking machine gun, man. Yeah. Hey, what does a farmer do? He throw one seed? Mm-hmm. One seed time out, come on, man. It's for the win for your family. No, come on, get up, raise up in the dirt, brother. Come on. Seeds after seeds after seeds after seeds after seeds, and guess what the farmer knows? It's a numbers game.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not going to treat people like a number, but it's a what? It's a numbers game. Remember this. You can't beat the numbers. I don't care how good you are. You can't beat the numbers. And the numbers can't beat you. Did you hear that last part?
Yeah.
The numbers can't beat you.
Yeah.
The numbers cannot beat you. So however bad you suck. When I heard that years ago, dude, that's awesome. If you could say the numbers can't beat me, so I suck right now. Like, so if I just do the numbers, they're not going to do that. Is a freaking, you know, the numbers can't beat you. Spread wide. I'm going to share, I don't have my PowerPoint, but I want to share some stuff with you about spreading wide and what happens after that. Accountability. Attitude, sprint wide, sell out to your op night, sell out to your op night, sell out to this big event, sell out to all that stuff. Let me tell you why. Op night, oh, let me do this. When we went from 6,000 to 6 recruits and 0 money, we told ourselves, you know what, we're not going to keep doing this the same way. We're going to change our process, okay? And we're going to sell out to op night, and we're going to go from, at that time, 30 people showing up to op night. And I told my guys, we're going to have 100. Now, did I know we're going to have 100? I just said, we're going to have 100. It's called vision talk. And remember this, it's free to do.
Hmm.
It's free to do, but it costs you everything to not do it.
Right.
Think about this for a second. There's gangs that out recruit you. There's an op night going on tonight, yes or no? In the hood. And they're talking about bring your cousin.
Right.
He's in all the qualifications. Yes or no? He's a
pedant. Right.
And they sign up, yes or no?
Right,
and
right.
They sign up. You're like, dude, what happened? You're holding up like that. Graduated, what happened? Because the leader speaks with what?
Vision.
Vision. Always remember this. Once a person leaves high school and they get a job, they don't have vision no more, so they'll buy yours.
Wow.
They don't have vision no more, so they'll buy yours. Paint a picture and somebody will buy it. If no one's buying your picture and no one's showing up to now, your picture sucks. Does that make sense? Because we went to Bobby Guisson's house, and this dude, I rolled through his house, I go, that's a, oh, you're recording them, that's it. They might get back to me. I go, that's an awkward looking picture. How much is that worth? Oh, this one's worth 20 million. That is worth 20 million. Bro. My niece, I think about that one. But to the right buyer,
right,
to the right person, to the right person you're talking to, guess what? They'll buy it. If you didn't got anybody coming tomorrow, then guess what? You need to work on your vision. Start telling people where you're going, not where you're at. Start telling people I'm going to be promoted. I'm going district leader. They might say, you running your own district, girl? Yeah. Yeah, you doing it like that? Yeah, I'll be a regional too. You, we all region? All Dallas. Talk like that. Hey, you know what's the greatest platform that you all should be using? Is social media.
Mm-hmm.
Social media, we all pretty much have one, yes or no?
Yes.
And guess what? We all watch it, yes or no?
Yes.
I mean, if you did this on your phone, more times than you do this in Facebook in a day, you'll be a billionaire. Going through your phone scrolling, you do more of this on Facebook than you do this on your phone. But anyway, that's a different meeting. Show the recognition. Show pictures with the $1 million earner here. Because guess what? All they're showing is their food.
Yeah, that's
guess
true.
So.
That's
all
true.
All they're showing is look at my freaking carne asada or look at my frijoles, right? It's not every day you're in a picture with a millionaire.
Right.
It's not every day you're in a picture with $100,000 earners. Show that. That's attractive. And this is what type of business? It's attractive business.
That's true.
Off night, we went from 30 to 100 in a month. 30 in attendance to 100 in 1 month. So once you hit 100, did we stop there?
No.
We said, we're at 100, let's do 200. And guess what? We start talking about 200. This is my base shop. Not my hierarchy, this is my base shop. And went from 100 to 200. And we start picking up 3 IPAs at op night. And then we start picking up 10 IPAs at op night. And then we start picking up 15, 20 IPAs at op night. And by the end of the year, we had 300 people in attendance at our op night, y'all. And we picked up 50 IPAs.
Already. At op
night. 50. So op night, you're fishing with the net.
Mm-hmm.
Do you get it?
Yes.
You're fishing with a net instead of a one-on-one with a pole. And I'm saying you do the one-on-ones with the pole, don't get me wrong. But off night, you can what? I'm fishing with a net. Off night is everything. You could have a great attitude. You could have an accountability. You could sprint wide. You could have a great off night. But here's the thing. If your environment is not exciting, then everything dies.
Mm-hmm.
A fish has to have what to survive?
Water.
Water, that's called environment. A snow, what type of weather does snow have to be in to survive?
Cold.
Hot? Cold, yes or no?
Yes.
Or the snow what? Melts away. Environment is everything. Environment is freaking everything. See folks, there's no such thing as bad kids. Just bad parents.
There you go.
There's no such thing as a bad dog, just bad owners.
Mm-hmm.
Does that make sense?
Yes.
Environment. I don't know if you ever seen the show, Cesar Millan, you ever seen that show? Yeah. The Dog Whisperer? Yeah. Dude, that's a great leadership freaking television show, and I don't watch a lot of TV. And I look at this leader of dogs, I go, dude, this dude's powerful. he's leading dogs, dude.
Dr. Doolittle.
And they call him and say, hey, man, I want you to come out and check out my dog because he's biting people and he's running out the house. Like he's a ghetto dog. You let the ghetto dog. You know what I'm talking about? Those ghetto dogs. You got to chase him and lead to your dog. And he goes over there and he looks at the dog, right? And first he says, I got to rehabilitate the owner. Let me fix the owner. And then I work on the dog. So he has a chit-chat with the owner, and if the dog is really bad, I love this, if the dog is really bad and they can't fix him on a weekend, they take that dog and they bring him to the environment. And these dogs know how to act. These dogs have high standards. Seriously. That dog, that ghetto dog, walks up to the gate and he starts barking like he's in the hood still. And the other dogs are in there, the environment, and his environment, they just look at him and go, boy, we can't wait till you get in here. And they let him in, and instantly that dog gets fixed, gets shut down. Because the environment, you get it?
Mm-hmm.
Because the environment, that dog goes back to the home, how you think that dog behaves now? Because the owner's fixed and the dog's fixed, it's a beautiful thing. High standards. High standards. How about this one? Why don't you go and be curious and hire 10 directs this month? See what that'll do for you. We had a guy last month do 28,000 in personal business last month as division leader. 28,000. He's just somebody thinks, what? That's called high standards. So when the next person walk in the room, guess what? Guess what? They go, I can do that.
Mm-hmm.
I can do that. You get it? Yeah. Let me bring it home further. And I know this might contradict some people, but I'm just going to say it. I understand you're one recruit away from explosion. I understand that whole concept. But what I really preach, and this is what has exploded our income, is you're in an environment away from an explosion. Because if you were truly one recruit away from an explosion, let's look at the NFL. Probably one of the suckiest teams ever is the Browns.
Yeah.
Yes or no?
Yeah.
They haven't won since I've been born. That's a long time. And every year, they get what? The top draft picks, yes or no?
Yes.
They get the top draft picks, yes or no? Because if you're that bad, you get the best picks from college. And guess what? You could pick that star talent. You could pick that star talent that was good in college and put them in an environment. And guess what? They'll eventually suck.
Mm-hmm.
That's that one recruit away from explosion. But then you look at the Patriots. The Patriots for years have dominated. And the Patriots don't get the top players. The Patriots get what? Round seven.
Mm-hmm.
Tom Brady, 199th pick. And you put them in that environment with Bill Belichick and his coaching and his philosophies, and guess what? You can turn that dud into a stud. Because the environment, does that make sense?
Yes.
Not bad kids, just bad parents. Environment got to be right. The sixth point I want to give you is what got our business going in the right direction is we started teaching replication instead of duplication. There's a difference. Let me give it to you. Miss, what's your name?
Crystal.
If I told Crystal, repeat this, what's your name? Elizabeth. Crystal, repeat this to Elizabeth. Primarily sat back in 1977, Art Williams, Cash Value Suck. If I gave her a whole list of things, and she tried to repeat it to Crystal, and Crystal tried to repeat it to my man, what's your name?
Jordan.
By the time it got back to my man, what's your name?
Jason.
It's going to be something like McDonald's party. 15, 15. Right? I got to go to the bathroom. I'm like, where the hell did that come from, dude?
Yes.
That's the problem with duplication. Eventually, the message gets watered down. Replication is different. Replication is this. Replication, I tell it's Crystal, right? Crystal, the message. Well, better put it this way. Let's say we're in a car, me and Crystal are going to an appointment, mm-hmm. and I put on a CD, and Crystal likes the CD. And she goes, man, that's a good CD. I go, you like it, girl? She goes, that's good. I go, let me get you a copy. Burn her a copy. I get your name? Elizabeth. Elizabeth hears the CD. And Elizabeth goes, dang, Crystal, that's a good CD. Crystal says, you like that? I like it. Go see Art. And I burn her the same exact copy. And my man, what's your name again? Jordan hears that CD and goes, man, that's an awesome CD. Where'd you get it from? I want it. Go see who?
Art.
So they all hear the same message.
Right.
So now everyone hears the what? The same message. That's called replication. How does McDonald's do it? How does Starbucks do it? Replication, yes or no? They don't do duplication. Because if by the way, if you bought a McDonald's, you know how to act. You can't put jalapenos in the burger. You might go, man, I got this great idea, dude. I do this at home. And no, guess what they'll do? They'll take the franchise from you. That's how important replication is. So we don't use 14 different presentations. I don't let district leaders teach. What are you teaching about? You a district. No disrespect. But there's three stages. I think I talked about this on the call the other day. There's a stage for learning.
Mm-hmm.
You gotta learn. You gotta take notes. You're learning. You gotta learn. Everyone's like, I'm still learning. I'm gonna learn this weekend. You learn. And if you're learning right, then guess what? Then you're earning.
Right.
If you ain't earning, then you need to go back to learning.
Right.
If you ain't earning, you need to go back to learning. How to get it correct, how to prospect, how to write a sale, you gotta go back to that part. And then if you're earning, then guess what? If you're earning, by the man Tony Stevens, then guess what? You should teach. Because
mm-hmm.
I want to hear from a $500,000 earner. I want to hear from a $1 million earner. I don't want to hear from a thousandaire. Because you only going to teach me how to make a what? A thousand. Do you get it?
Yeah.
So I've written presentations before. I walk by, go, what is that? Well, I got this from Sauce, and I'll give you that.
Nicely.
Yeah, let me get you ours. This is how we make burgers over here. That makes sense?
Right.
I know Carl's Jr. is cool, right? But this is how we make burgers over here. Okay? I'll watch you. All right, you got it? All right, good. Replication. And the last thing is you got to go deep. The person with the person that has the talent, the person that has a skill level, you should be going deep, all the way China deep. That as far deep as you can go. Because I went from 6,000, six recruits,
mm-hmm.
zero in pay. And when I said I sprinted wide with a great attitude, I'm gonna be a millionaire already because the money hasn't caught up to me. I went prospecting. And by the way, how you prospect, it don't matter. You could cold market prospect, you could referral prospect, you could social media, however you feel comfortable, it doesn't matter. Shaq didn't go pro on shooting free throws. Shaq didn't go pro on 3-point shots. Shaq mastered his inside game, yes or no?
Yes.
He always practices free throws. So you gotta master prospecting, however you feel comfortable is how you feel comfortable, but you gotta do it. And I went prospecting because at that time, I think Facebook just came out. There was no Facebook, there was no Instagram, there was no Snap, nothing, there was no your mama this, none of that stuff. It was MySpace.
Mm-hmm.
And I was a little freaked out, dude. Like, I'm not opening up one of those. Tom, I don't want one more time. I never met him. On my page all the time, I'm good. So everything for me was what? Cold market, referrals, anyway. So I'm at the mall, and I think about this all the time, and this will happen to you. You pass by winners every single day.
Mm-hmm.
You pass by winners every single day. You pass them up every single day. And what's the definition of poor? People overlooking opportunities repeatedly. You pass by people every day. You just don't talk to them. You don't call them. And this guy was walking towards me with a motorcycle helmet. Great attitude. I'm a millionaire already. And I said, excuse me, sir. He goes, yeah, what's going on? I go, are you looking for work by any chance? He goes, yeah. I go, what kind of work? He goes, actually, anything right now. I go, do you work right now? He goes, yeah, I work at Osh. And, you know, I go, are you looking to work anything specific? He goes, man, anything right now. The reason I asked, I just opened an office right here. I'm at zero pay, but I'm passing on what? Vision. I just opened an office right here. I didn't tell him, man, please join my team. I'm dead broke, man. If you just join my team, I'll win, bro. Come on. No, I walked as if. I just opened an office. I'm looking to staff it with some part-time people, some full-time people that want to make a couple extra $1,000. Hey, listen, man, I don't know if you'd be a good fit to come work with me. I'm taking it back now. Taking it back now. He goes, why you say that? I go, I just don't think you, I don't know. You might not be good fit to come over here. He goes, well, I think I'll be a good fit. I'm a pretty fast learner. He starts selling himself to me right there.
They go, listen, I'm going to call you. We'll set up an interview. Come to my office, right? With motorcycle helmets, it's crazy how things work, man. God is so good. God is freaking so good, man. Sit down with them, and I don't even recruit them. I said, listen, if you really want to do this, then you'll come back tonight at 7 o'clock for my off night, and, you know, we'll go from there. And he goes, all right, and he came back. Can't say the wrong thing?
Right
person. Attitude is everything. Comes back, do the off night, guess what? Falls in the office, goes, how can I do this? So it cost, I think it was $99 at the time. $99, background check, you know, so you qualify, all that stuff. He goes, all right, let's do it. Do his orientation, cast a vision, and tell him this. Now, mind you, six recruits, zero. Acting as if, right? And I go, listen, dude, I'm going to have a contest for you and only you. That's all I have. You're special, right? You bring 10 people to the op night next week, I'm going to give you $100 cash. Now, my wife was in the room. Where she went? But I'm not operating out of fear, I'm operating out of faith.
Right.
I didn't have $100. And guess what happened? This fool, next week, dropped freaking 10 people. I'm going, 1, 2, 3. I don't know if he's old enough, dude. I'm 18, right? He goes, I'm 18. I'm like, is this all yours? You sure all 10 are yours? They're all yours. Now, yeah, this is my friend, this is her, this is girlfriend, this is my other friend. These 10, these are all my people. Aren't you proud? Aren't you? Yeah, I'm proud. I ain't got them. I'm proud, man. But I go, you know what, dude? I'm going to do bad. I'm going to write you a check. Okay? But I had some banking problems. I really did have some banking problems. I have some banking problems right now. So do me a favor, dude. Cash this check in like 5 days. You go? Yeah, no problem, dude. You're good. Now, guess what? I already had appointments.
Yeah.
So guess what? I got 5 days. We go on appointment, brought up his aunt, booyah, $70 app, brought him up, booyah, go see his grandpa, booyah. Those, by the way, those 10 people that came, 3 of them signed up. So how many people am I training now?
4.
I'm in the money now. Yeah. I went from 6,000 to 30,000 the next month.
Wow.
From 6 to 30, not no year later.
Right.
See, a champion's not meant to be on the ground. You got to get up. I got up. $30,000 next month. Start making some money. And guess what? Start going deep and deep and deep and deep and deep. And from that, man, I wish I could have showed you the slideshow. From that one guy, see, you got to start looking at people differently. If I had seeds in my hand, I ask you, what do you see in my hand? What are you going to tell me?
Seeds.
And really, there's a forest there. There's not no seeds there. There's a forest there. If you throw those seeds in the right environment, a forest will grow. And guess what? From that one guy, I got 4 RVPs from that one guy.
Wow.
4 RVPs from that one guy. I have 5 regional leaders from that one guy. And I went from zero pay to knocking on 600,000 before August is over.
Yeah.
Woo!
Yeah.
Woo!
Yeah.
I mean, not to mention, you know, I mean, just, and by the way, when I show my stuff tomorrow, I'm not showing it to brag, maybe a little bit. But I'm showing it because one decision can make for your business.
Mm-hmm.
You're one decision away from that changed life. It's not good enough here in Primerica. Not good enough. Now you got to make a decision to be great in Primerica. And I look back, man, and I go, man, Brandon quit. And I stayed. See, when things get tough, that's when you find out character.
Yes, yes.
That's when you find out your character. What's that saying? You want to find out a person's flavor, put them in hot water?
Mm-hmm.
Or put like tea bags, put them in hot water, you find out the flavor? My flavor was what? I ain't going nowhere. You could take everything from me. You could take my car, you could take my house, you could take everything from me, but as long as I got my business, then guess what? I could recreate that.
Right.
Yeah. Right.
Just look at my business, I go get it again.
Yeah.
You can take it all again right now. Guess what? Leave me Primerica, I go get that shit again.
Yeah.
No big deal. I'm not gonna go to a job, because guess what I know? I could never get anything there. I just live a life, but I'll never live a lifestyle. Brandon quit. He left me millions. Millions. And I saw him the other day at Victoria Gardens. And I go, bro, let me give you a hug. I'm serious. You don't know what happened. I go, thanks for believing in me, bro. I gave him a hug. I go, you need to come back in business, dude. Seriously. He goes, nah, man. I go, bro, let me sit down and show you. What happened? And I showed him, not out of hate, but out of, dude, just come back.
Mm-hmm.
And I will get out of retirement to work with you, because that's how much you believe in me, helped my life. Mm-hmm. See, folks, this weekend is about two things. One, you're going to be Brandon. Mm-hmm. One, you're going to be Brandon. When it gets tough, because it will, it's supposed to.
Mm-hmm.
It's supposed to. It'll be one of the toughest things you'll ever do, but guess what? It's worth it. It's worth it retiring your mama. It's worth it buying her a car for Christmas and telling her, Mom, who's your favorite kid? If there's any doubt now, it's over now. Traveling, we just bought a place in Cabo, vacation home. I was telling TK, we just closed on another home where I'm at right now. That's called the reward. But I was willing to go to the risk to get the reward. Brandon wasn't. He just wanted the reward, like most people. Tough times never last, but tough people do.
Right.
We're finished with this, because the other type of person is going to happen from this room. The other type of person is going to happen from this room. There was they're trying out for the Olympics, and there's a high jumper, and this guy came in, no one's heard of him, and he comes in and sets the world record for jumping the highest, and qualified for the Olympics. And they interviewed him after and said, hey, who are you? We never heard of you. This is your first time, and you come in and you break the record, your first jump? Dang, who are you? How did you do that? And he said this, he said, all I did was throw my heart over the bar, and my body followed. I just threw my heart over it. You gonna be Brandon, or you gonna be the Olympic gold medalist? Either way, you gotta have a heart. And if you don't have a heart, you're going to quit. If you got a heart, throw it over. Throw it into Primerica. Throw it into the leadership. And trust me, you're going to set records. And I'll come back another time. I'll see you at the convention. I'll see you when I see you. And go, you know what, Art? I was that fool that at the weekend threw my heart into this business. And guess what? I just won RVP, brother. I just got my $100,000 ring. I just went over 200,000. I just won SVP. I just retired my mama. Who's ready to throw the heart into a business? Come on, y'all. Who's ready for the heart attack?